Hello guys, good morning, welcome to my channel. So as many students and aspirants were asking me to do some revision questions, so I thought of making the revision questions with respect to FSSAI assistant, with respect to the specific topic of FSSAI and current affairs. So this video series will be completely with respect to the FSSAI topics and current affairs, which will help you to fetch more marks in your FSSAI assistant examination. So there was also speculation regarding the postponement of examination. Still, we are not sure about it. So please don't take it easily that the exams will be postponed. Please focus on the preparation. So if it is postponed, then you have more amount of time. But who knows, it may not be postponed also. So don't take any risks until the FSSAI officially releases any notification. Okay. So with that, now let us start this class, first class of revision. So CEO of FSSAI is, because these kind of questions are most commonly asked because the different hierarchies and the persons with related to the hierarchies are also asked. So I will be adding only those important questions which I felt these would be of some importance for the assistant examination. So here the options are Arun Singhal, Rajesh Bhushan, Rajiv Kumar Jain and Sunil Bakshi. So here the answer is Shri Arun Singhal. Okay, he is also an IAS officer. So usually the top bureaucrats, that is IAS officers, will reach these kind of posts. So answer is Arun Singhal. The chairperson of FSSAI. So here I had asked regarding CEO, that is Chief Executive Officer. But here I am asking about chairperson. Please remember this because he was a new appointee, new person. So there are high chances of getting this question. So who is the chairperson of FSSAI? So it is Rajesh Bhushan. Okay, please remember this. For which of the following crops the National Food Security Mission launched in 2007 and 8 does not apply? So there are four options provided, and which of the following does not apply with respect to the National Food Security Mission? So the answer is oil seeds, because oil seeds are not included in the National Food Security Mission. Usually near the fair price shops you can see the rice, pulses, wheat, ragi, edible oil will be provided, but not the oil seeds. So answer is D. So I have given you the explanation also. The National Food Security Mission was launched in 2007-8 to increase the production of rice, wheat and pulses through area expansion, restoring soil fertility, creating employment and enhancing the farm level economy. Core cereals were also included from 2014 and 15. Okay, so human sterility is caused mainly due to the deficiency of, so sterility is losing the strength to reproduce. Okay, so the human sterility is caused mainly due to the deficiency of vitamin E. So due to deficiency of vitamin E, human sterility can be caused. You can see it has multiple functions in human and animals. Its key function is protecting the cell from oxidative damage. Since its discovery, several studies have demonstrated that vitamin E deficiency causes impaired fertility in humans and labs. Okay. So next question is CCCF stands for. See, this is also very important because the topics related to codecs are very important and the abbreviations are very important, because in last time there were two questions on abbreviations in the whole paper. So it is better to remember all the abbreviations. Okay, I will get a separate video on it also. But till then, let us study what is the full form of CCCF. So the answer would be Codex Committee on Contamination in Foods. See, all the options look similar. So if you know the perfect answer only, you can attend these questions. So you have to be very accurate in these type of answers. So the answer is Codex Committee on Contamination in Food. Okay, so you can see it, CCCF establishes and endorses permitted maximum level levels of guidelines levels or for contaminants and naturally occurring toxicants in food and feed. Okay, food standards for product specification is given by which of the following Indian authority? So the options are FSSAI, FCI, BIS and APIDA. So this is a basic questions where everyone will be knowing. So the answer is FSSAI, and a detailed explanation has been provided, and I have already explained this so many times. The intention of putting this question is that all of them in some or the other way is related to food standard, because APIDA is related to agricultural products, and BIS is for quality certification, and FCI is for Food Corporation of India, which procures food by providing MSP. So everything is with respect to food itself. So you need to be specific here. Food standards for product specification is given by FSSAI. Okay. So AgMark stands for Agriculture Grading and Marketing Act, Agro Industry Grading and Marketing Act, Agriculture Grading and Management Act, none of this. So the answer would be Agricultural Grading and Marketing Act. So the answer would be, please remember, as I said, abbreviations are very, very important. So please remember the abbreviations also. Food Safety and Standards Act 2006 consists of number of chapters 9, 10, 11 and 12. So this is also important because there are different schedules. And chapters. So similar to the type of Indian Constitution, there are different schedules. For Indian Constitution, there are 12 schedules. So likewise, FSSAI has a number of chapters. So what are the number of chapters? So the answer would be 12. So please remember this. This can also be a static question from FSSAI part. So there are 12 chapters in Food Safety and Standard Act. Okay. According to FSSAI, DASH shall not be below the rank of subdivisional officer to be in charge of food safety administration in such area as may be specified by regulations. So who among the following would suit this fill in the blanks? That is the food safety officer, designated officer, assistant commissioner and commissioner. So the answer is designated officer. So as you know, designated officer is a very powerful post. So above FSO, that is food safety officer, above him designated officer will be placed. So he'll be having a huge amount of powers, and FSO can inspect in any organization or restaurant with the permission of a designated officer. So please remember that. According to FSSAI, DASH shall be responsible for inspection of food business, drawing samples and sending them to food analyst for analysis. See, these kind of questions can confuse you, and you may think that these are the easiest questions, but you can see in the previous question also similar type of question was there but different intention. Here also the different intention has been put to you. So who will be responsible? So the food safety officer will be responsible to do any inspections. Okay, so he will be the responsible person, and he works under DO. Okay, that is a designated officer. So these were the total 10 questions for today. So I'll be doing every day 10 questions so that it will ease your preparation for FSSAI assistant. So that's all for today, guys. Thank you.